He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Okay, today's practice problem is going to be about dimensional analysis. The first question asks, express 1.00 ounces, or 1 ounce, in liters. So we are going from ounces to liters. Now, just to give you the relevant information, in order to do this conversion, we will need to know that 1 liter is equal to 1.0567 quarts. And we also need to know that 1 quart is equal to exactly 32 ounces. So that is not an approximation. That is exactly 32 ounces, just the way that there's exactly 1,000 milliliters in a liter, that sort of thing. So that value will not limit the number of significant figures we are able to use. So bear that in mind. That is the relevant information for that question. And then the next question we want to answer is as follows. A packaging material has a density of 47.93 kilograms per cubic meter. And we want to express this in grams per cubic centimeter. So we do have to do some conversions there. So if any of this is unclear, go ahead and check out my tutorial on dimensional analysis. It's going to give you all the strategy that you need to be able to solve these kinds of problems. And once you're ready, go ahead and give these a try. So let's answer this first question. Remember, we want to convert 1.00 ounces, or 1 ounce, into liters. So we have some conversion factors here that we're going to want to use. Now, what should we use first? We want to cancel out ounces, right? We don't want ounces, we want liters. So let's use the conversion factor that has ounces in it. That's going to be 1 quart equaling 32 ounces. So let's multiply 1 ounce by 1 quart over 32 ounces. Remember, we are always going to be multiplying our value by things that are equal to 1, and we achieve that by using fractions where the top and the bottom are equivalent to one another. They're just being expressed differently, because that won't change our value. It'll just give us different units. Now, it's very important that we put ounces on the bottom, because that is how we get ounces to cancel. Now let's use the other conversion factor. We have 1 liter over 1.0567 quarts. And it's very important that we do this way so that quarts will also cancel. So let's go ahead and cancel our units. Ounces are going to cancel because we have ounces and then we have ounces on the bottom. And then quarts are also going to cancel because we have quarts on the top and quarts on the bottom. So just like algebraic variables like x in algebra, these units are going to cancel this way. And the only unit left is liters on the top. And that is what we wanted. And if we set things up this way and we end up with the units we want, we know we did the problem correctly. So now all we have to do is the arithmetic. So now let's just quickly assess sig figs. We've got 3 sig figs in the first value, 1.00. Those trailing zeros are significant because they are decimal zeros. The 32 is unlimited. As we said, that is an exact conversion. It's 32.000 with infinite zeros. It is precisely 32 ounces. So that will not limit our sig figs here. And then we have 5 sig figs in this value. So our answer must have 3 sig figs. Those 3 sig figs are going to limit our answer to 3 sig figs. So we go ahead and plug this into the calculator and we get 0.0296 liters. And that will be our answer. Now let's look at the next problem. We have some packaging material like a styrofoam of some kind. And the density of this material is 47.93 kilograms per cubic meter. And remember, we want to get this in grams per cubic centimeter. So what are we going to do? Let's write down our value. We've got 47.93 kilograms over meters cubed. And once again, we can treat these units just like algebraic variables. So meters cubed literally means meters times meters times meters. And we can write this out this way, which will be useful in helping us wrap our heads around exactly what to do. And we'll see why in a moment. First, let's take care of kilograms since that's by itself. We don't want kilograms, we want grams. So let's use the conversion factor 1,000 grams over 1 kilogram, because that's going to get rid of kilograms. Those will cancel out, and we will end up with grams, which is what we want. Now let's take care of the meters. We don't want meters, we want centimeters, so let's use the conversion factor 1 meter over 100 centimeters, because those are equivalent. There are 100 centimeters in a meter. And the reason we do this is because meters will cancel. However, only one of those meters has canceled. We need to cancel all three. So we will need a second conversion factor of 1 meter over 100 centimeters. That will allow this second meters to cancel. And then we need a third conversion factor of 1 meter over 100 centimeters to get the third meters to cancel. So we needed to multiply by this conversion factor 3 times, not only to get rid of those 3 meters comprising the meters cubed, but now we have centimeters times centimeters times centimeters, which is centimeters cubed, which is what we want. So we don't necessarily have to do it this rigorously, but this is just to illustrate the fact that having meters cubed converting into centimeters cubed is not the same as just meters to centimeters. We cannot use that conversion factor 1 time. We needed to use it 3 times, or at least 1 time cubed. So that is how we needed to do this particular problem. And now we have grams, which is what we wanted, and we have centimeters times centimeters times centimeters. We will have an answer in grams per cubic centimeter, which is what we want. And now all we need to do is plug these numbers into the calculator. We have 47.93 times 1,000, and then we want to divide by 100 1, 2, 3 times. So we want to divide by 100, and then divide by 100, and then divide by 100 again. And if we put all of that in the calculator, we will get 0.04793 grams per cubic centimeter. So none of these conversion factors are going to change the number of sig figs. We have 1,000, we have 100, but those are all exact conversions. There's exactly 1,000 grams in a kilogram. So we are just going to have the 4 sig figs that we started with in the initial value. And so that is why our answer has 4 sig figs. And that will be the answer to this problem.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.